Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So, I don't know how you could call that, but I did purchase one of the versions of their album. So, I don't know, I would call it like character development, right? I instantly fell in love with the S version, so it's like one of the limited edition. The cover is absolutely stunning. I purchased it even before seeing, hearing the medley or like seeing the teaser for this comeback. I did see the teaser pictures though, and I was like, I was intrigued. I was like, okay, you piqued my interest. Let's see, right? But then I saw the cover and what was in the album, and I was like, I need it. It is probably one of the prettiest cover I've ever seen in terms of album. So I was like, yeah. This is it. And so yeah, not to toot my own horn, but I kind of feel like it's a character development. Like, I can't call myself a stan or whatever just yet, but it's definitely like, I'm feeling some things, right? And so I feel like Dreamcatcher has changed my opinion regarding, like, you know, the rock sound in the K-pop industry, especially for girl groups, you know, so little by little, all right? Little by little. So I can't call myself a stan just yet because I'm not that familiar with the members. However, how can I choose a bias when they all look incredible? They all sound incredible. Like the teaser picture, I kid you not, what, Gayeon, excuse me? Like, I think this is going to be her era. I feel like everybody's gonna fall for her. Even if she's not your bias, she's gonna be your bias wrecker. I'm just assuming, just saying. But she looks absolutely stunning with those pink hair. Oh. And Dami with her blue hair, oh my god, don't even get me started. Anyway, so with that being said, I'm a bit early again, so there are no English captions just yet, so this is called Boca. From my 5 years of Spanish high school, that means mouth, so there you go. Anyways, so the first frame is the tree of life. No, I don't know. That was one of the elements that was in the Scream music video. We will see the mask again as well, so yeah, I wonder how that ties in together, you know, theories and everything. I still got it. So with that being said, let's just go ahead. So this is the part to lose myself. Got you. Damn. The power that had. Ah, yes. Oh! Oh, am I delusional for wanting an Alexa and Dreamcatcher collab? Oh, yeah. Oh my God. How am I supposed to choose a bias though? The aesthetic, holy crap. Oh. Stunning. This era, visually speaking, this is probably one of the songs that are going to be like, this is, the bangs! Wait! Wow. Oh, yeah. This girl! Oh, yeah, yeah. Smirk? Oh! Demi can like, can step on me. Wow. Wow, these, oh, the visuals, holy crap. Yeah, I was, as I was saying, this is going to be one of those songs that are going to work with more people. I feel like, wow. Oh yeah, yeah. This is the moment where I stop understanding, right? Wow, yeah.
Oh, wow.
All the shots, like the close-up shots are, wow. The mask, there we go. Oh. Visually speaking, this is their superior concept. All the close-ups shots are absolutely stunning. The details, the makeup, the every little thing, every little element of this fashion, makeup, hairstyling, everything about this, stunning. This must be one of the prettiest music videos of this year as well. Somehow when it comes to music videos, I know that Dreamcatcher are known to have very aesthetically pleasing music videos, but this one is a little bit better in my opinion than a lot of their other previous music videos. I would describe most of their previous music videos as fantasy-like, you know, inspired aesthetic. In this music video, in this era, it feels more ethereal, more fairy tale type of fantasy still, definitely still fantasy-like, but there's definitely something that is a bit more ethereal-like about this, and I find this absolutely stunning. Very much Uju Sonyeo, you know, this type of thing, stunning. And like I said, I believe this song is going to be appealing to a larger audience. Like, it's something that I said also for Scream. I said that I think this is going to be one of the songs that are going to speak to more people because it sounds less rock. The way I see things in the K-pop industry, rock sound is not the most popular. It is liked by a niche of people and some people can enjoy it, but they wouldn't, you know, say that this is their favorite style or genre. I would be one of those people, you know? And so I definitely do think that the rock sound is not like something that is going to be easy for a group to break through in the industry. However, when you mix it with something else, like they do, like they've been doing, you know, they've been doing it. But I believe that Scream and this one are going to be speaking to a lot more people because it's a mix of, here I would say it's a mix of like more Latin inspired sound. Like I had some feelings of like hard in here as well, so maybe that's why I kind of link it to the more Latin sound. Correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, it's kind of like a mix of two genre and it works so well. Oh, and Boca is in Spanish, so that would make sense. In my personal opinion, it is a perfect blend of those two genre, and they do it so well. And they do it so well, it's like so perfectly blended and it's not harsh, it's not hard to digest, it's very very easy to listen to. And the raps, excuse me, the raps, like those two, I feel, like, listen, I love Seon. Seon was the first member who grabbed my attention really, but nowadays I kind of feel more, I don't know, attracted to Dami and Kayeon, and I can't help it. Deep voices, oh, they get me every time. It's crazy because like they are both rappers, but they give off such different vibes when they rap. I feel like this era is going to be their shining moment and I hope it goes crescendo because they truly deserve it. I feel like, as I said multiple times, Dreamcatcher is a group that is so freaking talented overall and they have such an incredible discography, and it just takes a few people, a few more people to discover them, to give them a chance to really change everything. So I hope that this time around a lot more people will give them a chance. And honestly, this type of music video is going to be a selling point in my opinion. This music video is absolutely stunning, like it's breathtakingly beautiful. So I hope to god that they get their first win. I hope to god that they get more recognition and everything. That being said, to me that was an incredible comeback. I loved the vocals, obviously I preferred the rap this time around. The raps just got me very very strongly. I loved how the dance had this point, this key point, you know, the boca thing. Love that as well. This is a great comeback and I cannot wait to get my album because I want to flaunt it. It is absolutely gorgeous. Anyway, that is it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.